Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Welcome every one of us that is watching right now. Welcome to Glory Impact Apostolic Global Ministry. Welcome to today's miracle and revival service. I pray that you will receive your miracle even this very day in the name of Jesus. I want us to begin to give thanks unto the Lord. I want us to begin to give Him praise. Give Him praise wherever you are right now. Give Him praise. Open your mouth and give Him praise. Give Him praise. Let God hear your voice of thanksgiving. Let God hear you giving Him thanks for making you to see the end of the week. God has been faithful. God has been faithful. He has been awesome unto you. You're going out and you're coming in. The grace of God has kept you. Why don't you give Him praise? Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Give Him praise. Hallelujah. Give Him praise wherever you are watching us online right now. Wherever you are right now, begin to give Him praise. Father, we worship you. According to Psalm 109 verse 30. Psalm 109 verse 30 says, I will greatly praise the Lord with my mouth. Psalm 109 verse 30 says, I will greatly praise the Lord with my mouth. Yes, I will praise Him among the multitude. Among the multitude, give Him praise. Let God hear you giving Him praise. Among the multitude right now, let Him hear you giving Him praise. He said, I will praise the Lord with my mouth. Yes, I will praise Him among the multitude. Give Him praise, give Him praise, give Him praise because He has counted you worthy. Give Him praise because He has made you to be alive. Give Him praise because He did not leave you to the kingdom of darkness, to the plan of the kingdom of darkness. He has preserved your going out and your coming in. Give Him praise, give Him praise. Father, we give You praise. Father, we worship You. We say thank You, Jesus, for all the benefits we have received from You. We say thank You, Jesus, for all the blessings we have received from You. We say thank You, Jesus, for all the goodness You have bestowed upon us and our family. We say thank You, Jesus, for everything You have done for us. Father, we say thank You, Jesus. We give You all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are giving thanks. Romans chapter 3 verse 23 says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. He said, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Therefore, this very hour, I want us to cry out unto Him that He should forgive us every of our sin. I want you to cry out unto Him, Lord, forgive me every of my sin. In any way, I have come short of Your glory. In any way, I will not receive Your glory in today's miracle and revival service. Oh, Lord, forgive me. Oh, Lord, forgive me. Oh, Lord, forgive me. Jehovah, forgive me. I know I have sinned against You. Jehovah, forgive me. In the name of Jesus, I know I have fallen short of Your glory. But right now, I pray that You will forgive me, oh, Lord. That, Lord, I will see Your glory in today's miracle and revival service. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. According to John chapter 4, verse 24, say, God is a spirit, and those that worship Him must worship Him in truth and in spirit. I want us to pray, Lord, let my spirit be tuned unto Your spirit to receive from You this hour. Let's open our mouth, begin to pray. Lord, I want my spirit to be tuned to Your spirit, oh Lord, because Your word says, those that worship You must worship You in spirit and in truth. Father, let my spirit be true to You. Let my spirit be true to Your Holy Spirit, that I will receive from You. Except Your spirit is true to the Holy Spirit, you cannot receive anything from Him. Are you ready to receive Him into this miracle and revival service? Cry out unto Him, Lord, let my life be tuned to You. Let my spirit be tuned to You in the name of Jesus. Let my spirit be tuned to You in the name of Jesus. Let my spirit be tuned to You in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Isaiah 44 verse 3 says, I will pour water upon him that is thirsty, and flood upon the dry ground. And I will pour my spirit upon thy seed, and my blessing upon thy offspring. We are thirsty. Our heart is thirsty. Our soul is thirsty. Our career, our business is thirsty. And we need a revival. We need a miracle. And the book of Isaiah 44 verse 3 says, I will pour water upon him that is thirsty. If you are thirsty right now, you are thirsty for a miracle, you are thirsty for a revival, I want you to cry out unto God. Lord, according to Your promise, pour out Your water upon me. For I thirsty, O Lord. Lord, I thirsty for miracle. I thirsty for revival. I thirsty for your touch. I thirst for Your touch, O Lord. Father, touch me in the name of Jesus. Touch me, Holy Spirit. Let heaven be open, O Lord, that You will touch me, O Lord. For I thirst, O Lord. And Your word said that You will pour water upon him that thirsts. Lord, I thirst this very hour that You will pour upon me, O Lord, Your word.
water, even as I desire you to revive me, even as I desire, oh Lord, a miracle. A miracle concerning the works of my hand. A miracle concerning my family. Oh Lord, my Father, I test, oh Lord, let there be flood upon my dry ground. My life is dry. It's dry of that beauty. It's dry of that blessing. It's dry, it's void of that glory. Oh Lord, my Father, release your flood. Let heaven be open and release your flood over my life. Release your flood. Release your flood. Release your flood upon my dry life. Release your flood upon my dry life. Release, oh Lord, flood of testimony. Release, oh Lord, flood of testimony upon my life. In the name of Jesus. Remember, this month is our month of testimony. That is the word of God that God has given us to our Father in the Lord. Upon this mountain, upon the mountain of Gilgal, pray that the flood of testimony will be upon you, upon your dry ground, so that your life will begin to have testimony. Oh Lord, according to your word, that upon the dry ground, my cry, oh Lord, let there be flood of testimony in the name of Jesus. In today's miracle and revival service, oh Lord, my Father, I pray that you release your flood, flood of testimony concerning the works of my hand, flood of testimony concerning every member of my family, flood of testimony over my life, in the name of Jesus. As he has prayed that prayer, that let God release his flood, because that is his word. Isaiah 44 verse 3, flood upon the dry ground, that ground that has no testimony. This is our month of testimony. There will be a flood of testimony in the name of Jesus. Father, release it now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. According to Psalm 109 verse 26. Psalm 109 verse 26, it says, help me, O Lord my God. Save me according to thy mercy. Father, we pray that you will help me. Pray that God will help us in the name of Jesus. According to his mercy, he will save us in the name of Jesus. Psalm 109 verse 26. The mercy of God will locate us in the name of Jesus. God will help us. He will send his miracle and revival in our lives in the name of Jesus. Even as he's going to use our Father in the Lord in our midst this very evening, as he's going to use him as his oracle, I pray that, Lord, you will send help through him in the name of Jesus. Your word through him will be like a fire in the name of Jesus, and our life will be like a dry wood in the mighty name of Jesus, and there will be a revival in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you always answer. Lord, if I will commit the remaining program, the Holy Spirit, you will have your way more than ever before. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen, amen, amen. In Jesus' name, settle. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Today is another wonderful day in the presence of God. Let us begin to appreciate God for how he has been helping us from the very beginning of this week, this very moment, for his protection and his provision over every one of us. Let us begin to appreciate him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
praise, give him glory. Nobody can be compared to him. Let's worship him. Give him glory, give him praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm serving the Lord of miracles. I know, yes, I know. I'm serving the Lord of miracles. I know, yes,
I know.
I'm serving the Lord of miracles. I want you to sing that song. Serving that God of miracles. In this miracle and remember service, the Lord will touch you.
Yes, I am
serving a living God. I am serving a living God. Serving a living God.
I am serving a living God.
I am serving a living God. Serving a living God. Are you serving a living God?
I am serving a living God.
I'm serving a living God.
I am serving a living God.
I'm serving a living God.
I am serving a living
God. The Lord that seated upon the circles of the earth will give you praise. The Lord that performed miracle per seconds will worship your name. We want to thank you for bringing us, oh God, to your presence this evening. We want to thank you for this platform, online service. Thank you, Lord, for testimony that we have been hearing. Thank you for people that have been healed, delivered, and saved. We say, be that glorified in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Tonight, Holy Spirit, there is somebody there that you need to touch. There is somebody there that have desired a miracle. There is somebody that you need to revive. Holy Spirit, we have touched them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As you are saying amen right there where you are, let your desired miracle be delivered into your hands.
Amen.
Be delivered to your hands. Be delivered to your hands. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said to me that many, many people, their lives, their business, their family has withered. And some, they are already dead. Some are already dry. But the Lord told me that every withered life, every dead life, every life that have been barren, tonight you will receive the quickening of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God will enter into you afresh.
Amen.
The Lord said, I should prophesy. Remember when the Lord asked Ezekiel to prophesy to dry bone? He prophesied to that dry bone, and the dry bone lived. They become a standing soldier. Those that are dead, that are dry, I shall prophesy. The breath of God will enter into your life.
Amen.
Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 9 and 10 says, then said he to me, prophesy to the breath and spirit, son of man, and say to the breath and spirit, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath and spirit, breathe upon this slave that they may live. God commanded to speak to breath and spirit, and he spoke to them. They came from the four corners of the world, from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. I want to prophesy according to the word of God. And he says, so I prophesy as he commanded me. And the breath and spirit came into the bones, and they lived and stood up upon their feet, an exceedingly great host. I want to prophesy right now. Everyone watch me right now. Everyone listen to me. I prophesy. I call for the breath and spirit from the four corners of the world. Right now to your situation, I say, live in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let that business that is dying, live right now.
Amen.
You, that boy that you are, that your blood is getting out, your blood is drying, and you are looking thinner every day. I speak to your body. Now receive healing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the breath of God enter into your womb.
Amen.
Every dead womb, receive the breath of God.
Amen.
Receive the spirit of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, whatsoever is dry or that is dead in your body, I command spirit of life to possess you right now. Live in the name of Jesus. Live in the name of Jesus. You will not die. You will live. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Settle. If you're happy to be in his presence this evening, come and shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
A big, big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to welcome everyone. Listen to me right now to this revival and miracle service. This is a special service that the Lord has orchestrated for you to be blessed, for you to be delivered. And I want to believe that that's your desired miracle this evening shall be added to your hands.
Amen.
I say right now, it shall be given to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Spirit of God asked me to minister on this topic. Deliverance from your familiars. Deliverance from your familiars. That is the topic we are looking at. We are in the era that we need to be careful, extraordinary vigilant with everyone that is close to us, with everyone that we know and that knows us intimately. Now, these days, it is not COVID-19 that is more deadly. There are people that are more deadly, that are closer to us, that can take off our life, that can ruin our destiny, even more than COVID-19. But the attention of many people now is COVID-19, coronavirus. But the Lord told me that we should not be taking, or we should not allow the issue of coronavirus, not to allow us to see the prevalent evil that the kingdom of hell is perpetrating in the life of people. We are hearing about kidnapping, isn't it?
Yes.
We thought that coronavirus era is going to put an end to kidnapping. But no, this day we are here. How can the world be passing through this kind of, and we are still hearing about raping? Today we are hearing about robbery attack. We are hearing about assassination. All this evil, they are being perpetuated by our familiars. When investigation is being carried out, we find out that the work, all this raping, assassination, all this kidnapping, they are the works of our familiar. No other people than the people that are close to us, no other people that are people that are known to us. And they are destroying life, they are destroying destiny. I read about a family. This family has a boy and a girl. And this young girl was alone at home, and to her brother that was also in another institution, learned that this lady was the only one at home, and she came in, raped this young girl and killed the girl, unknowing to him there is a CCTV camera in that house that they just installed. The man is a pastor. So the man are dead, and when they investigate, they look through at the CCTV. It was the friend of a brother. Can you see that? It is not issue of COVID-19 that is killing people alone these days. Deadly people are surrounding us. So when we're talking about deliverance from your familiars, you must pray very well. And this message is coming to us so that we'll be more vigilant. Not be suspicious, but to be more vigilant. When I'm talking about your familiars, who are they? Your familiars are members of your household. You'll be surprised that there are some deadly things that members of your household are doing that can kill, that can destroy, that can maim destiny. Your members of family, it can be your brother, it can be your sister, it can even be your father, it can even be your mother. We heard about father raping their daughters. Recently, last week, we heard in the news that the man lost his wife 5 years ago, 2015, and started sleeping with her daughter, and she has aborted 3 times for this girl. These are the evil that are prevalent. Members of one's family can be dangerous to our life and to our well-being. When we're talking about your familiars, one who often see you, everyone that sees you every day and is well known to you, he knows the time that you are going out. Some people where you live, they already know that on so day you will be out, and it will remain your children alone at home. I was surprised when somebody was telling me yesterday, he said, Pastor, I know that on so day you will always go out. You will not be at home. This our familiar. If anything is going to happen, it is that person that is well known to me, that knows the time I go out, that knows that I'm not at home. Your familiars, they are your intimate associates, your companion, all your intimate friends. Hallelujah. You can say you have friends, and this is a close friend. You have friends, it's an intimate friend. There is no sin about that. But do you know, if care is not taken, this intimate friend, this close friend, this close associate can bring evil upon someone. But I want to pray for someone that is hearing me. Any members of your household, anyone that knows your out, that knows you very well, or anyone that is intimate with you, companion or a friend, if they are having any deadly plan against you and your family, let it backfire. Let it backfire. I'm talking about deliverance from your familiars. Your familiars can also be your family friend. Like the one I just narrated to us. That boy was a family friend. He was well known to them. In fact, the mother of the girl that he killed, anytime he's buying a cloth for his own son, they're so close. So they don't expect that. When they watch the CCTV camera and they discover that he was the same guy that came to their house anytime, that is free, that can enter into their house anytime, they were shaking. He said, the clothes that is even on you, I bought this clothes for you when he was arrested. So close friend can be deadly than coronavirus. Association of old friends. There are some old friends that many of us belong to, say association of old friends. You have not known, you have not seen for some time, but you now form association. They can be deadly. People in the same community where we live, people in the same in the same workplace, they are our familiars. In our community, in the workplace, in the street, in your environment, they can be deadly. That is why the scripture says in the book of Micah chapter 7, verse 5 to 6. I want to pray that Holy Spirit will give you understanding.
Amen.
And He will deliver you.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit will help you to know how to take precaution, to know how to be vigilant about who God has given to you. He said, Micah 5, 7, 5 to 6. Don't trust anyone, not your best friend or even your wife. For the son despises his father. The daughter despises her mother. The daughter-in-law despises her mother-in-law. Here what it says, your enemies are right in your own household. Hey! Your enemy are right in your own household. In other words, your enemy, they are not far fresh. Your enemy are the people that are close to you. Your enemies are the ones that live with you, that die with you. When we are talking about familiars, I'm not talking about familiar spirit. There are familiar spirits, we all know that, in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 10 to 12, told us about the activities of the familiar spirit, necromancers, sorcerers, and the rest. And it said that anyone that is doing this abomination, God hates them. Familiar spirits in their own, they are demonic spies sent by the devil to the life and families of people with the sole aim of sabotaging their plans and effort to succeed in life. That is the work of familiar spirits. They are spies. They are monitoring spirits. Sorcerers and mediums, they use familiar spirits to gain information into a person's life. That is what familiar spirits do. You will see, not everyone you know, or not everybody that knows things about you. Some people that say they know things about you, they prophesy to you. You think that it's from God. Not everyone that says something that is correct, that is right about your family, that is speaking from the Spirit of God. Many of them, they use familiar spirit. Some are just using familiar spirit to gain information on you. And they will use that information to manipulate you. You believe that they are prophets of God, is operating the gift of God. Let me tell you, there are some prophets that they have some familiar spirit. This spirit will give them information. They are spirit that monitor. It is not the Holy Spirit of God. So I'm not talking about the familiar spirit. We are going to deal with familiar spirit some other day. But now, I'm not talking about spirit. I'm talking about human being. Because you say, who are my familiars? No, I'm not talking about spirit. I'm talking of human being. That are deadly. Don't put your face on virus. There are deadly virus, human virus, that you need to keep social distance from. That you need to cover your mouth, your nose. That they must not come near you. People that you have to, you cannot even shake. Because when you shake them, you are in trouble. People that you cannot even sit with, you cannot visit them. Those are the people that we are talking about. And today, the Lord will rescue you from their hands. Hey. He will deliver you. Hey. Say, oh Lord, my Father, deliver me from my familiars. Deliver my children. Deliver my poor from the familiars. In the name of Jesus. Say amen.
Amen.
I want to believe you are understanding what I'm saying. Jeremiah, in the book of Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 10. Hear what Jeremiah said. You are going to see, I want to begin to tell you the operations of the familiars now. Jeremiah chapter 20 verse 10. He says, I have heard many rumors about me. Now, Jeremiah was the prophet of God. Jeremiah is somebody that is loaded and God raised him to bless the people of Israel. To bring them out of bondage and to show them the way of the Lord. But he said, I have heard many rumors about me. You see, rumors and unfounded lies, they are one of the instruments of our familiars. If there's anyone that says that there is rumor, there are lies, if you find out the person that engineered that rumor and lies, they are not far-fetched, they are close to you. And you know, many people have been destroyed by rumors, by unfounded lies. They have destroyed many destinies. Before their benefactors, before their helpers. Your familiar will hear that somebody wants to assist you, somebody wants to help you, and the next thing they will go and do is to go and steal rumor and lies. I want to pray for somebody. Anyone that your destiny has been ruined by rumors and lies, today let the Lord deliver you.
Yes.
Let the Lord deliver you.
Yes.
From your destiny helpers, anyone that wants to go and lie against you so that you will not receive that help, let the Lord disgrace them.
Amen.
Let the Lord disgrace them.
Amen.
Say, oh Lord, my Father, deliver my life from rumors and lies in the name of Jesus. Now, is that not deadly? Is rumors not deadly? Rumors, somebody said, and lies. Somebody said, in my face. To a friend, he said, I did not know you. I'm meeting you for the first time, but I hate you. Because I have heard many things about you that made me to hate you. This person, I've not come in contact with them. They don't do business with together. It just hate him. Why? Because of rumors and lies that somebody have told about him. He said, but today, when I met you, I discovered that those things were lies. Hey, can you see? If blessing is coming towards that person, this person that didn't know him, but somebody that knows him, that spread rumor and lies against him, he begin to say, I've heard so about this man. Don't help him. Don't do this. And he did not know him. Every activities of rumors and liars against you, against me, let it backfire. So he said, they call me the man who lives in terror. That's what they call Jeremiah. They have called many of us different names, our familiars. Those that are close to us, they have given us name. And that name makes people to hate us. He said, they threaten. If you say anything, we will report it. They twisted our words. It is not what you say that they report. They give negative reports. And this negative report is affecting your progress and your breakthrough. Hallelujah. So these are the activities of familiars. Familiars twist your word. You will say one thing, they will twist it. You will mean one thing, they were going to say another thing. They misinterpret your words. And that is why you must pray, Lord, deliver me. This is, you have good intention. You really want to bless them. You want them to move forward. They will twist it And they will give a negative report that will ruin your life. Can I pray for somebody? Any negative reports that have been spread about you, any negative report affecting your breakthrough in life today, let the Lord scatter it.
Amen.
Let the Lord notify that report.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Listen to what Jeremiah said. He said, even my old friends are watching me, waiting for a fatter sleep. He said, even his friend, they are waiting for him to fall. Anyone waiting that they are expecting that you will soon make a mistake, you will soon fall, they will wait in vain.
Amen.
You know, there are some of our familiars, they are not happy when we are making progress. They are not happy when we are doing well. They are just, it will soon fall. That is their prayer. It will soon make error. I pray for you. Anyone praying that you will make error, anyone praying that you will fail, in the name of Jesus, they will fail.
Amen.
In fact, right now, somebody, you are listening to me. This is what is affecting your growth. This is what is affecting your life. Today, I pray everyone that has set a trap before you, that have put a stumbling block on your way for you to fall, I pray in the name of Jesus, they will fall into their trap.
Amen.
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 It's a pity that people that are very close, our familiar friends, our families, seek nothing than our downfall. If your family did not sell you out for evil, no evil can befall you. I want you to know that it is our family, our friends, close associates, intimate friends, close people that knows us in the community, workplace. This family, they are the one that sell us. They are the one that pass us information. Hear the experience of David too. David in Psalm 55, verse 5, 12, and 3. Hear what David says. He said, fear and trembling overwhelm me, and I can't stop shaking. When these activities of family are started, David said, fear and trembling overwhelm him. He can't stop shaking. He said, it is, verse 12 says, it is not an enemy who taunts me. Hear that. I could bear it. Ha! He said, it is not my foe who so arrogantly insult me. I could have hidden them from there. Instead, he said, it is you, my equal, my companion, and my close friend. How can someone be a close friend? How can someone say he's a companion? How can one say he's your colleague and he's the one that is taunting you and he's the one that is doing evil? I want to pray for you. Any of your close friends, your equal, your companion, anyone in your family that is taunting you today, let them be judged in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the Lord judge them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, when we are talking about our familiars, they are the ones that pass informations. Anyone that is going to be assassin, anyone that is going to be maimed, anyone that they wants to do any evil, they work by information. The world is governed by information. People that knows your secret are the one responsible for your attack. People that knows the time you go out, the time you come in, they are the one responsible. That one that will, organize people that will say, yes, go and attack him. He's going to pass through this way. So people that you are told that you are traveling, okay, I'm traveling, they will ask you, okay, oh, God, mercy, journey. They will even pray for you, speak in tongues, but they have sent people. Yes, it's going to pass through this place. So there is information. And how did they get information? People that are close to you. Because if you don't tell them you want to do this, they won't know. You divulge your secret to them, and they use it against you. Today, everyone monitoring you, taking information, and is sending you to evil people. Today, the Lord will arrest them. For example, the man that was traveling through the highway and fell between armed robbers, must have been set up by his familiar. Armed robbers work by information. If you see any armed robber that attack a place, they work by information. So the man have been traveling with some valuables. He was attacked and seriously wounded to the point of death. That was in Luke chapter 10. Jesus made the parable, Luke chapter 10, verse 30 to 35. Likewise, many of us in the journey of life, we are moving towards the place of our destiny fulfillment, but we have been attacked by spiritual robbers, wounded, and many died in the process. Listen to me, many people in life that would have made it big, By today we would have been hearing of them. They have killed them. And who killed them? Who assassinated them? Their familiars. They just informed them he's traveling and he has a huge amount of money in his hand. So when you attack such person, please, this is my percentage. They gave information to assassin, to hang robbers. I've seen a child, a boy, that gave his friend information about his father. My father is bringing money today. Please don't kill my father. Just make sure that you collect the money and give him my share. And the process, they got his father killed. He passed that information. Looking for your information, or that want to work on your information to destroy you, let alone arrest them. So Jesus said about this man, he was maimed, he was stripped. They stripped him of his clothes, they beat him, and they left him half dead. Then by chance, priests came along the way. They saw the man lying there, they did not help. Temple assistant came there, they left him, until one a Samaritan, we called him Good Samaritan. And this good Samaritan came, carried this man, take him to the hospital, bind his wound, and even paid for the hospital. I want to pray for somebody. Maybe you have been maimed, you are almost gone, you are almost dead. Let the Lord send you your own Good Samaritan.
Amen.
That will bail you out.
Amen.
This man that was attacked by armed robber, his family has sold him out. But look at how God did it. God now brought somebody that is not close to him. Somebody that is not near, that did not know him. Help him. God is sending someone that you don't know. Even this era to you, they will help you.
Amen.
Three things happened to this man that was attacked. They stripped him of his raiment, that is his glory. And what remained was shame and nakedness. If they have stripped you of your glory, if they have stripped you of something valuable in your life and now you are naked, today, let the Lord clothe you back.
Amen.
Let the Lord restore you.
Amen.
Let the Lord restore you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, he was wounded. Glory wounded. He was wounded and is suffering chronic embarrassment and delay. Today, if you have been wounded and your glory is suffering, today, let the Lord heal you.
Amen.
Oh, you are not saying amen.
Amen.
I know many people will know what's happening. That's why you must pray this. You must pray when it's time for us to pray. Any of your family that is planning to wound you, even this era, they will wound themselves.
Amen.
And the Bible says, they leave him half dead. Living, but not existing. Today, anyone that is half dead, your life is miserable. Today, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
Now, let's look at different type of people that come his way. A priest, a Christian saw him pass by, a Levite, possibly a kinsman. People close to him, they did not help him. But the Samaritan, a stranger, had compassion on him. I want to pray for you. Somebody that will have compassion on you this season, the Lord will send you your way.
Amen.
Say, oh Lord, my Father, have compassion on me. Send compassion to me in the name of Jesus. Look at what this person, he's not his familiar. He did not know him, he just met him. Most of the time, when God is going to bless you, he's going to bless you through people that are not your familiar, people that don't know you. You discover that many people that promote you, that help you, you don't know them. Why is it that it's our familiar that ruins us? He bind up his wound, that he give him inspiration and hope. Somebody, you are listening to me. Someone that is going to bind up your wounds, where they will give you inspiration and hope this time. May the Lord send it to you. Depressed this time, they are depressed. They are depressed. They are not happy. But they just need a word of encouragement for you. Not for you to destroy them. There are some familiars that will look at you this time. They will look at you and they begin to make you to be more depressed and frustrated. They don't give you a message of hope. If pour oil and wine, that is lubrication and happiness. Somebody is going to give you happiness, joy. They will meet you this week in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then they took him to the hospital and paid his bill. If not for the mercy of God, that sent the Samaritan man, the man would have died without fulfilling destiny. He cleaned his wound, bind it, took him to the hospital and paid all the charges. What a perfect helper and perfect mercy. Say, oh Lord, my Father, send to me a perfect helper that will show me a perfect mercy. Send to my children a perfect helper. Are you praying? You are receiving your miracle now. A perfect helper. I need it this time. In the name of Jesus. Lord, send to me. In the name of Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. Lima Santaraba. Reketale Ushataraba. Yes, in Jesus' name we pray. You see, Jeremiah says something, and I want you to pray with that. When all these people rumor and lie against him and they want to kill him, he said, but the Lord stand beside me like a great warrior. Hallelujah. Amen. You see, when the Lord is beside you like a great warrior, he delivers you from your familiar. I want you to rise up wherever you are, and you are going to pray. Say, hold on, my Father.
Hold on, my Father.
Stand beside me. Like a great warrior, in the name of Jesus, stand before my wife, my children, like a great warrior, in the name of Jesus. Malika Setaria, Antaye, Indeketomo, Ende Atilia Gadose. Lord, stand beside me like a great warrior, in Jesus' name we pray. Can you sing this song with me? Say, fight my battle, Holy Ghost, arise so and fight my battle.
Fight my battle.
Fight my battle. Holy Ghost, arise so.
Fight my battle.
I say, fight my battle. Fight my battle. Holy Ghost, arise so and fight my battle. Can you sing that song? Holy Ghost, arise so and fight my battle. I say, fight my battle. Fight my battle. Holy Ghost, arise so and fight my battle. Oh yes. Holy Ghost arise so and fight my battle. Hey! Holy Ghost arise so and fight my battle. Amen. The Bible says, before him my persecutor will stumble. Hallelujah. They cannot defeat me. They will fail and be thoroughly humiliated. Their dishonor will never be forgotten. Say amen, somebody. Say, oh Lord, let all my persecutors, my familiars that are full of evil intention, let them fall before me in the name of Jesus. Are you praying? Let them fall before me. All my persecutors, all my evil people that I call friends, people that are called, that are close to me, let them fall, 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 let them fall. In the name of Jesus. Are they for my family? Are they in my community? Are they my community? Are they close? Let them fall, 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 let them fall and fail. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, I cannot be defeated. Familiars will not defeat me. Say, in the name of Jesus. I come against every activities of my familiars that is planning to destroy me. Say, oh Lord, arise. Scatter them in the name of Jesus. Scatter them. Scatter them. Scatter them. Scatter them. In the name of Jesus. Lord, scatter them. In Jesus' name we pray. I want to read the book of Micah chapter 7, verse 7 to 8. Say, as for me, I look to the Lord for help. Who do you look for the Lord for help? Say, I look unto the Lord for help.
I look unto the Lord for help.
Say, I wait confidently for God to save me. And my God will certainly hear me. God will save you. Because somebody said, where would you run to now? Because our family, they are members of our household, my close friend. Hey, you do know that some people, you call them prayer partner, and they are very injurious to your destiny. Prayer partner. Not cause partner. Hey, they can be your familiar. But he said, God will save me. God will save you.
Amen.
He said, do not gloat over me, my enemy. For though I fall, I will rise again. Anyone listening to me, maybe you are falling already by the activities of familiar. God is taking you up again. Yeah. The Lord will lift me up. I will rise up again. He said, though I sit in darkness, the Lord will be my light. The Lord will be my light in the name of Jesus. I love this thing. He says, the Lord will help me. I am confident that he will save me. He will save me. You are going to sing this song before you pray. Rescue me, Baba, rescue me. Rescue me, Holy Spirit, rescue me. Rescue me, Baba, rescue me. Rescue me, Holy Spirit.
Rescue me.
I say, rescue me, Baba, rescue me. Rescue me, Holy Spirit, rescue me.
Rescue me,
Baba. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, rescue. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, rescue me. Amen. Say, Father, bind the eyes of my familiars. Don't let them see me. Don't let them see my program. Don't let them see my children. Bind their eyes. Blind their eyes. Blind their eyes. Let them go blind. Every family monitoring me. Go blind. Go blind. Go blind. Go blind. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You know why I said God to blind them? Because they walk by information when they see. And you are going to pray. Lord, close their eyes. Let them be deaf and dumb. When they are the common sorrow. When they want to go and bring information, they will just be deaf and dumb. Say,
oh, my Father,
close the ears of my familiars. Let them be deaf and dumb. Let them be deaf and dumb. In the name of Jesus. Close their mouth. Close their ears. They will not hear my information. They will not know my secret. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, every rumor and lies about my personality by my familiars today, be nullified, be nullified, be devoured, be nullified, be nullified, be nullified, be nullified. Every rumor, every unfounded lie against me. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, oh Lord, my Father, deliver me from negative reports. In the name of Jesus, deliver me from false accusation. In the name of Jesus, say amen. Say, Father, keep my breakthrough a secret to my familiars. Make it a secret. In the name of Jesus, my breakthrough, make it my testimony, make it a secret. In Jesus' name we pray. You know, if you are going to get testimony in life, God must have delivered you from your familiars. Because most activities of the familiars don't allow you to have testimony. Herod asked the wise men, come, tell me about Jesus that I may kill him. He wants to know about Jesus. He wants to kill him. Anyone that is gathering information so that they can kill you today, let their plan fail in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, the Lord did not allow these people, the wise men, to go and inform Herod again. Anyone that has information about your life, that knows you when you are growing up, that knows when you start business, that knows when God is giving you breakthrough, and he wants to sell you to the hands of assassinators, in the name of Jesus, let the Lord deliver you.
Amen.
I want to pray for somebody. I want you to say amen. You will not fall to the hand of armed robbers.
Amen.
You will not fall into the hand of thieves.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let somebody shout, say my destiny.
My destiny.
Reject accident.
Reject
the death of my children.
Yes,
reject accident.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, deliver me from destiny destroyer.
Deliver
my children from destiny destroyers.
Destiny
in the name of Jesus. Lord, deliver my destiny.
In the name of Jesus.
Deliver me. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Put your hand on your head wherever you are. I want to pray for you. Your destiny will not be wounded.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every wound you have sustained as a result of your familiars, today I pray for you. Let the Lord bind you up.
Amen.
And heal you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray this season, let the Lord send to you a perfect helper.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
People that will have mercy upon your life. In the name of Jesus, at the right time, people that you need to help you, let the Lord send them to you. In the name of Jesus, I pray for someone, you won't fall into error. You won't fall into a mistake. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you today, let the Lord avenge you. Anyone that have done evil against your destiny, that make your life to be like this, today, the Lord will avenge you. From today, your family will not prevail. In the name of Jesus. You will fulfill destiny.
Amen.
I will fulfill destiny.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord said I should pray for somebody. He said he wants to lift you up before the end of this month.
Amen.
If you are that person, the anointing of lifting,
amen,
let it rest upon you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, you have made proposals. Listen to me. And they have not signed your proposals. Before this time next week, that proposal will be favored.
Yeah.
It will be signed.
Yeah.
You receive new contracts.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
There is somebody right now you need healing. I'm praying for healing. Let the healing power of God fall upon you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Fall upon you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Somebody, you are experiencing deduction instead of increase and enlargement. Every power that is stealing from you, every power that makes to be reducing, today, let the power die in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
According to Psalm 115 verse 14, it says, the Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children's children. Today, I pray, anointing for increase. Anointing of increase. In the name of Jesus. The Lord will increase you. He will increase your family. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said, I should pray for favor. That you need favor. The Bible says, and Jesus increased in wisdom and status, and he was in favor with God and man. Today, receive the favor of God.
Yeah.
Receive the favor of God.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I say, woman, you are listening to me right now. You need comfort. The Lord needs to comfort you. The Lord says in Psalm 71, verse 21, thou shalt increase thy greatness, and it will comfort you on every side.
Amen.
Every comfort that you need, every side. Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Say to let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your life is revived.
Amen.
Your miracle is in your hand already. Go and make it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
By God's grace, I want to thank everyone listening to us. I want to thank everyone that is connected to us every day. And on your YouTube channel for the daily prayers, it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
On Sunday, we are meeting on Sunday by 10 a.m. for our glorious service. Make sure that you tune in and you connect with us on Sunday by 10 a.m. On Monday, I've started a series this Monday, Apostolic Impact, and we are looking at how to make impact in this generation. Please make sure that you log on. Tell all your children they need this message, and the Lord will bless them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please make sure that you log on to our YouTube channel, Glory Impact TV, for your daily prayers. You will surely be blessed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We want to take our offering. Our account number is on the screen, 271-655-9019. FCMB, and the account name is The Glory of His Coming. You see, this time you must give to the advancement of God's kingdom, advancement of God's work. And I want someone to miss this need. We need a generator, we need a laptop, and we need a video camera to enhance this work. As you have provided this, the Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus. We are not beggars. We are telling you this so that God can bless you. And as you do this, you will surely be blessed in the name of Jesus. Rise up wherever you are. I pray that the Lord bless your offering. Let that all increase you more and more. As many people that are supporting us, the Lord will support you. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will never lack. In the mighty name of Jesus, so shall it be. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Until we meet next week, I will hear your testimony. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name, settle. Hallelujah.